कॉलेजचं मुलाधार आहे सर आणि इथं गौरी सी मुला स्वेटर and stay there till you get your realization. To come to England itself was really very venturesome and exciting. Because this is the heart where I had to come and work it out. And at this stage, when we see so many of you who are the cells of this heart, who are awakened, who are so united, to know each other, to understand each other, work together, pump the blood of love. It's really the most happiness giving, you can say joy giving, or the greatest fulfillment of my desire. I see you here working like small children, playing about, joyous, happy, giggling, helping each other, learning how to be one with each other. I really feel the blessings of God has come down on this earth. You know that heart is the most important organ in the personality of the universe. And the human beings have to become aware of that point who live here. That we have to live together, work together. If in the heart, even if there is one muscle who tries to stand out, it can create immediate instant death. Instant. So all of you who are awakened have a very, very special, very, very special response. Now, I've noticed there are two types of people, as we know that. Left-sided and right-sided. And the third type, which are the combination of both. And the fourth type, who are in the center. We have to belong to the fourth type. And here, one sees how, on the physical level, we combine both. One side is too much organizing, and too much of thinking. Another side is lethargic, laziness. All these things are there. The net result of both is that you cannot produce any results. If you plan too much, if you think too much, you end up with it. You are so fagged out to do anything. The left sided, so ultimate result is that you achieve nothing, even on the physical, the material, the mundane type, day-to-day life. So when you are in the center, you witness. You start witnessing. When you steady yourself in the center, because some people are such that they start on the left, go to the right, they become so ego-oriented that it's impossible to deal with. But if you stay in the center, that's the fourth side, is staying in the center. Turiya is the fourth dimension. If you could stay on that, then you become a witness. And that's the point where you start sucking the joy of every moment of every doing, of every work, of every friendship, of every relationship, of every understanding. You will see some people who will be here. We develop tremendous respect and friendship with others. Because they'll discover a lot of qualities, lot of talents, lot of beauties in other people. There's no other way we can find it. I think this is the greatest way one could provide, is to work together at to understand each other, appreciate each other's work. And this will help us again to work out Sahaja Yoga together. It is like a festival throughout, I felt, about the whole place. I'm so blessed with so many children helping me here. The work doing is not so important as yourself studying in the center. That's the main point. It's not what work you do, what work you furnish. That's not so important. It's the steadiness within you with which you do the job or whatever you do. It's the enjoyment of sharing with each other is the main part. It's the training. It's the training here. I hope we'll have another chance again sometimes. Maybe in India when we build our ashrams, or maybe in England when we build our ashram here, I hope so. Then we'll have again the same opportunity to work together for joy's sake, not for anything else, just for joy, for your steadiness, to be steady in the center, to put the attention in the center. Without studying it, you cannot ascend. Everybody seems to have gained, I felt, when I saw them, they are much better. So we have to give up our misidentifications with our previous styles of life, previous type of living, previous type of executing anyone. And we have to understand that we are not to plan. This house is built for me. I am the power behind the whole universe. So you don't have to plan. You just start off. But once you start planning, then you depend on yourself, which is a very limited thing. You just start planning and you are left behind. You just get to it. When you start thinking of any problems and all that, then you are lacking behind. Just start off and everything will come forward. You'll find everything. It will be all there just before you, before your eyes. Like the other day they said, we don't find a wood we need very much of a particular thickness. And they were trying to sort of reduce the thickness by rubbing it with some very, very harsh type of noisy stuff, which nobody could bear. So I just said, what? What kind of a thing you want? See ahead of you. And just in front of them was lying that same type of wood that they want. Just ahead of them. It was just there. You see how it's happening? What's working out? It's the Hanuman who works out many things for you. It's the Gauri who is to be adored. And it's the duty of Hanumana to help you out. He plays tricks with you. Always. You see, he is the one who makes you think, he makes you plan, he makes everything, and then topples you down. See, that is his stuff. Always. And he has made good with so many people like that. See that he made them think, plan, and ultimately they find all plans for him. So if you are too organized, you will never enjoy. You have to enjoy each other's company. You have to enjoy all the little things there are. If there is everything perfect or absolutely sort of a machine-like, then you go on tuck, finish. There's no enjoyment. You have to lose your way somewhere. You have to find something out. You have to go about. You have to ask someone. Like making mistakes also is important. Sometimes if you make mistakes, like somebody makes mistakes by putting the thing in an angular way. And it turned out to be a very beautiful thing. So making mistakes is also good. This is what I'm trying to show to all of you. By mistake also, if you are driven to some place, you might find something new. So our time is never wasted. Wherever we are, we are. We are never lost. We are never lost for anything. Time stops for us. So once you understand that we are not to worry about these things which the people worry, we are not to worry about things which for which people just give their lives, we are here for joy. And joy will come to us, whatever it is. So we should seek joy, happiness, friendship. And this is a very, very good opportunity. Luckily, the builder ran away. I was very happy. I wanted to have this opportunity, some opportunity where all of us could get together and work together and have some nice time together. It was really very enjoyable. I enjoyed it thoroughly. And
and I hope we'll have more chances to do that. But the more you are in collectivity and in witnessing state, the better it will be always for you in your other life, other things also. Because you are realized souls, you are saints, you are different people from others. You have the help of the gods. All the angels are helping you, everybody is helping you. But when you depend too much on your understanding, on your planning, then you go. Then you can never enjoy the planning of God, the help of God, the complete Rama, which is actually fine from God, is there, for that part. How beautifully it is done, how things working out, it's very interesting. This house is a very, very old house, see? And even if such an old house can be made so beautiful, then what about human beings? That all become very beautiful, glorified, and very active in such a very active. The whole thing is the experiencing of the joy of recreating something that is already ruined. Whatever God has created, human beings as such, is all in a mess. I feel human beings are in a mess. And they are to be recreated, they are to be improved, they are to be worked on. For that, who is going to work? It's you. You are the one who are to do it. I can create houses after create universes, as you know that. But I have to use you. You are the channel. Without you, I just can't do it. And that's why you have to be very, very alert, attentive as to how you go about. Now today is the first is for the housewarming ceremony, and another is the birth of Christ. I won't be here. I'll be in India. We celebrate in India birth of Christ. Actually, it should be more celebrated here than in India. But somehow or other, there's no Christmas, which was not there. The time of Christ, when he was born, there was no snow. But in India, it's a special blessing that you have snowy Christmas. And this time, I hope you'll enjoy, all of you, a nice Christmas of great warmth and love among yourselves. Christ came on this earth with a very, very great message for all of us. And he's done so much. You can see that without his awakening, you cannot make realization. You have to pass through him. He has made this way. To create the Agya Chakra in that beautiful way, and to keep it alive, and to give enlightenment, is a very difficult thing. It's a very funny plug into which we have placed him. Because of the modern style of life, people become against Christ. It develops your ego, it goes against Christ. If you develop your superego, of course it goes against your Christ. Against Christ. So, both the things, ego or superego, both the things are to be looked after by one person. Both, contrasting things, are to be looked after by one person. It's true. And these both things, both problems we have. So, when we are born, on this earth, we are born in innocence, which is also so rare because of the way we live, the way the fashion is, you can say, the way the ideas are. But you all have to be against, absolutely against, collectively, if you oppose these ideas, you stand for Christ. You must write to all the churches, all the people. What have we done? What have we done to our people? Where is the morality behind it? There is no morality. People are so immoral. How can they become saints? This is not the way to have just church buildings and run the Soho land for the church. Church is only the soul land. Can you imagine? All these things you must oppose, and you should say, we would like to know why. Why should you? When Christ said that thou shalt not have adultery, what about the chastity part of it? When are we going to look after all the Christian nations are just deposits of Christ's principles. And so you all have to prepare yourself, talk about it. So there should be no more silence. Public opinion is a very, very big thing in the modern times. That's a very, very big thing we have got. And silence is to be avoided, absolutely. Because people who are doing wrong have a conspiracy of silence. They conspire. And then they keep silent. All right, doesn't matter. Democracy, as far as as Chile is concerned,
all right.
But as far as Argentina is concerned, we'll be this way. It's like that. See, they keep a silent mouth. Whatever is not bad for us is good. That's all. And then don't say anything, don't say anything. Such yogis have to be extremely bold and extremely outspoken. And they have to say that this is all wrong, absurd. It is not for us. Not that they are uncomfortable, but it's against life, against Christ, against our emancipation. And this has to be given up. Today, you must vow that now, as your house is settled down, your backbone is strengthened, you have to take a vow that you will stand for Christ and for His great morals and for the great things He said that we have to be. And we have to tell people, what are you doing? This is wrong. You cannot do. They are more vocal when it comes to something degrading, like drinking. If you don't drink, they'll say, why don't you drink? They will force you. Why don't you drink? You must drink. You must have this. But when it comes to morality, nobody dares say anything. We don't discuss religion. Very good. This is the silent conspiracy. We don't discuss religion. Because if we discuss, we are not religious. So people have to speak about it. All of you have to speak. Then only your left issue will be all right. Now the only gift that will be working in the search of this will be that for Sahaja Yoga we are not doing anything. You must speak. You must talk about it. You must give realization. Move your hands, move your legs. You have to walk the cross. For God's work, even if you have to beg, you have to do it. This is God's work. Now one has to do that. God's work with all dedication, with all surrender, and with all down and enjoy. God bless you. I'm very happy. He is very much thankful to you. And he also wants to say a few words to you. He might come after the puja. He said, I would like to address to them. He's so surprised. And he said, these are really transformed people. I can see they are transformed. They are not normal human beings. So it's nice to get a certificate from a person. He said, I've seen now. I've seen them before. Especially he saw Marcus long time back, and today Marcus, he says, is so different. Everybody seems to be so much changed and so much different that I'm amazed how human beings can be transformed. He says it's visible from their faces, how they are happy with each other, how they are satisfied, how they are kind to each other and all that. He's very much surprised how they are so friendly and how they are so generous and all that. He was really surprised and how they laugh and enjoy. He was really surprised. He told me that. At least 10 times he has told me that really surprises me how you could transform these people into such beautiful things. So it's really a big certificate, I think, from him. He normally doesn't give certificates like that. So I was really very much enamored. And just to make your mother very happy, he's bought 2 saris for me today, which you will see later on. He's bought 2 gold things for me, just to say, glorify the mother of the nature. It's something I thought of the 3 wise men brought present for Christ's mother. You see, in the same way I felt today, the way he brought saris for me and gold for me and all that. Not for the anything of his personal, but in the way he saw that Sahaja Yoga has worked out. So may God bless you.
Thank you.
We have now, so accordingly, we should have only Ganesh Puja, because this is a Bhumi Puja, it's for Ganesha to be established. And it has double purpose, because it's the Puja of Christ and Puja of Ganesha. Just look at this, how sweet it is. So it's made by some Indians and it's very good. It is made by hand, you see, that's what is wrong, I found out. Yeah. It's all made by hand, because if it is not made by hand, you'll find those joints, you see, somewhere. There are no joints in there. So they have made, of course, 2 different things, but then they have tried to molds. These are molds, and then they have put it there. And this is for your ceramic. All right, so should we have the puja now of Sri Ganesha? Now, he's got 2 things for me. They'll be happy.
And this one is even better. I don't know. From Uruguay he got it, I think. Or from Peru. And this is all right, then I'll help them. Alright. I've discovered some great artists also
among you. One of them is Dawn. I never knew. She's a very great artist. And she's done some very good work on daisies. I was surprised. Beautiful.
Then we have got Rosie, another artist. And Linda is another person who is very good at painting. So many things I've discovered. And Danny is saying, yes, his name is Dynamic.
he's another very responsible person. Chris is a great person. I mean, one better than the other. You can't imagine. The other day I wanted to... Yes, madam. All right. Anything, you see, anything that they did was so remarkable. Even the skirting. And everything they do, they did it with such precision and this thing. Then I was surprised that Finn and John are such good tiners and the paper was put. I was really amazed at it, really amazed. Pat and Norman, they have done all this work. They, I extend this a factory for you, it's a factory work. Factory work you have done. And everyone, you see, was doing such good work. The greatest is for Wilson because he did all the plastering. And Gavin came and he gave the guru. And then Al, Ian was there. These people came from France. I mean, I can't, in one lecture, I cannot tell you how much I've seen it. So I'm saying for all of you, those who have worked very hard here, very, very hard, and did such good work, and such sensible things, and such nice, loving things, like really, it's surprising. How it has worked out. And Loha was there with his practical side of carpenter. And it's really remarkable to see he's so responsible, doing things properly, working it out. What's it? Now, Puli is coming to do some gardening work that I saw him doing there. He has to combine with other people and work it out. And work it out so that we should have a friendship. That's the main point. Be friendship. Not with you, but all of you should be friends. There should be love among yourself. And then Rosie has done so much work. The thing that surprised me was Kate, the way she's not, I mean, she's in a family way. And she was sitting down and doing all the cleaning and all that so sweetly. All the time she comes here, Graham took to it, then this Ruth came in and her husband Tracy was here, and then these people from Portugal, they came. I mean, there's no, it's so beautiful, you can't imagine. Everybody has been so nice and so good. And this lady has been the best of all eating away all my ladoo. Come, you take one now, Ganesha. Come along. Eat all that. You must take her photograph eating the ladoo. There's a saying that they ask you, children, if they play, they say, hello, mister, how do you do? So they say, just like a laddu, one buys two. Another silent worker is Yoga Singh also, who has done such a lot of cleansing. And the way he's dedicated. So, really what's in him, the way he's dedicated. Very silent, and he's doing the worst work is to clean the house. Very sweet of him, really, to do that way. It's very good, and it has done good to him. It's very surprising how he's done it with such understanding and it's very sweet of him. And we have got Kathy, and Kathy also comes down and she helps quite a lot. And Felicity is trying to do something smoothly about things. Everyone is working it out. And I like it. And there are people who have done so much work. And then Malcolm is doing nice painting. I can see that. He's done some nice painting on top. And Anne has done some papering. She's very good at papering. I was surprised, you know. She's very good. And who helped you, first of all, yesterday?
Phil
first, and then?
Alan.
Phil and Alan, they helped her to put the paper, which is a very, very, very... stuff. And then the energy was brought in by Ray from Brighton. and our great Mr. Yugoslav has done my room. He has done the, what you call, the loft. That's very interesting, he has done it. And also, she painted, what's her name? Janet. She painted the roof of my room. It was interesting. And David has taken out all the nails. This is also nails. Imagine nails. A lot of things. We are taking out so many nails like that. Life and all these things are happening. And I think, I haven't seen, but Bernard has, I'm told, has done some patching up. This is how we did. We have to patch up, we have to take out the nails sometimes, you see, you have to paint, you have to encourage, you have to glorify, you have to do all these things, so much is there. And everybody has worked so much here. Marcus has put some of these, and Danny has put, I mean, it's, I tell you, it's one by one, everybody has done. Chris has done the basics, which is all the basics of this, and Marsha has come to encourage, and, I mean, you can't say all of them have come, and the way even people from Hampstead came down to help us see their special dresses. And it was nice to see them in those raggy dresses, you see, because that's what it is. We don't see people in that dress normally. It was very, very good, very good. I tell you, really good. I enjoyed myself. And Jason and Jill, both of them came, and Jason with his backbone troubling him, you see, was also working it out. I mean, it was all that. Then we have Kay and Patricia. You see, Patricia, for a change, was rhythmically taking out the paper, you see. I could see the musician working on it. New styles. And the one who did our pillaring is from Australia, the great, you see. Hugo, the pillaring, he put pillars, you see, to support, to show that there is support. Support is needed. That's another thing. And then Susan came in, David, all these people, they helped us so much. It's, I mean, I don't know how many names I should take for everyone. And even people from Cambridge came down. Just to help me, yeah, everybody helping, and people from Brighton, I can say in general, all right? I will not take everybody's name now, because it is, we are so many that even if I take your 100 names, you see, you take my 100 name, is one person's 100 name is equal to the 100 names of 100 people, isn't it? So, that's what it is. And everybody should feel that I remember you all. Even I have to thank David Prawl, because he made us buy this house. All kinds of nice things have happened. And we have so many people over here. Maria, you also came. I saw you. But the best was Jack and Jill. Where are they? Are they here? Both of them came. David and Jack and Jill are there. David and his wife and Hester. Both of them came in a dress, you see, looked like Jack and Jill. And Maureen came one day, she did some good job, and I mean it was really good. We had Athena was here and they did some work, and everybody has put something in down here. And John Watkinson, I must say, was very good at putting up these roof things he has done. And this is done by Nick Hawk, but usually she says. They have been very, very nice and good for the festival. Okay, Don, you also came one day, isn't it? Don and his precious wife, Roxana, she came. All of them came down here every day. And somehow I was seeing one by one, it's working out. It's good. And the little girl from, what's her name? Allison? Allison, who came all the way from Bristol. All was very interesting. And I think you people also came from, Chile people came down. They saw him create, and here is someone great sitting. He also worked. One of them are, have done so much, so much. And I'm really happy about it. Veggies were there too. Veggies have done the basement. I think I've taken everybody's name. Everybody's name, I've not taken please raise your hand. Maybe, see, I think it's one of the questions here. And Datta was giving us a book for us all the time. And Ali came in and she was at my feet most of the time. And then we had Bumble who did the. Bumble did all the what? Coloring. Staining, she did all the staining, you know. And she also came and we had some bananas together. And you came and Samson, and all of them were here, like, this thing. And the way Pat, see, Pat is very much changed now, very different person, I must say, he's very happy, so changed. Now, very sweet, that his organizing way has gone away, and his wife also came to help us in a Yugoslav style, and no, I mean Polish. It was very, very good, I should say, the whole thing. Jeremy was sweet to draw out a very nice fireplace, and I mean everybody helped us. Now, Alan, who was the real architect behind the whole thing, I don't know if he's here, but he was of such a help. So you can tell him that, Mother, we love you very much, and all the people. He also helped us so much. See, all of you are really remarkable, all those who have helped and have been nice. Actually, you have helped yourself. And Harry was very sweet, and he was doing a lot of cleaning work. Sometimes he did. Getting problems. But he laughed at it and enjoyed it. He didn't feel bad. So that's how you have to make mistakes, at least not to feel bad about it. Something to do. It's very interesting to see how things go and how it just good. And you never came. She did come for a while. And now, what? Chelsea, you want Laddu? No. Now, come on. Finish this. Sit down. Now, I was thinking about, you see, she's already done something here, Kaliya. She's done her work, see? We can have a small puja of Ganesh, but it's a thing of festivity. Not to feel bad about anything, not to feel unhappy, but to feel happy. See, some people have hurt egos, some have ego, some have super ego. It's the occasion to feel happy. For everything that is there, and not to feel bad or want to feel unhappy. Some people might be feeling because I've not taken their things, maybe, or I don't have things, but I have a feeling that there's a little ripple of that somewhere. So just get over it. Just get over it. it's all that is there. I know all of you very well, and only the understanding comes through vibrations, how much I love you, solely through vibrations. And it was really to feel how you're receiving my vibrations. That's the main point. Who did the cutting? He does not do well. I must say, beautiful for my book. And what is this? What did you do? You were doing something. I saw you doing something.
Supervisor.
Bala also came to help us with his aeronautical knowledge. Well, yes, I did.
Nobody in the house, then the whole house they will say. So CP will come here. When CP goes back, then you can get the food. Wash. Come, let the children wash. Let these people come here. Now you, these three people. You have done one food, I don't think you have done one. So they are going away now, I will come. So Ganesha, you can keep it for a while with this one. Come and keep it. You can, because you occupy very little space, you can push it anywhere.
Saraswati Mata
Namaha, Sri Guru Bhyo Namaha, Vedu Shaya Namaha,
Krishna Devta Namaha, Kuldevta Bhyo Namaha, Standevta Bhyo Namaha, Gramdevta Bhyo Namaha, Vastu Devtabhyo Nama, Shachi Purandarabhyam Namo, Alkam Purshuram Bhyo Namaha, Matru Pitru Bhyam Namo.
Let him read.
Adityadi so Navagraha Devtabhyo Namaha, Sarve Bhyo Deve Bhyo Namaha, Sarve Bhyo Brahmanya Bhyo Namaha, Itatkam Pradhan Devtabhyo Namaha.
Now you sweep the Ganesha. Can get a towel. What is the towel? Are you washed? You washed.
Let our ears hear that which is true. Let our eyes see that which is pure. Let our beings praise that which is divine. And let those who listen hear not my voice, but the wisdom of God. Let us worship with the same song, the same strength, and the same knowledge. And let our meditation enlighten and enrich. Let there be amongst us compassion and peace.
See, compassion and peace. The peace comes out of love, out of understanding. Peace is a very important word today, peace. See, they forgot, as it is said, Ya Devi, Sarva Bhuteshu, Shanti Rupena Samsina. It's the goddess who resides within us as the peace within. Peace within is the goddess. That is the power of the goddess.
Now the prayer. Salutation Sri Ganesh, Sakshat Sri Jesus, Sakshat Sri Nirmala Devi, Namo Namaha.
Not all that, little bit.
It is you who is the beginning of all the beginnings. It is you who is the doer of all deeds which have been done, are being done, and will be done. It is you who supports all things that are supported.
So I should have said that I must thank Nirmala Devi also for doing everything. All right. Because I am beyond myself. All right? Little more than that. Can you now?
The towel is here.
Can you move it? You may take out this. Who will carry this water?
Stick it again.
We'll be there better. This water should be sprinkled all over the house, you see. And some you can take it if you want to Portugal. It'll be a good idea. See how much balancing is needed for water. Same is the attention. Same is the attention. You have to be in the center. Now, hard. Press it. Rub it very hard. Very hard. Better. See? Now, Gavin, you read. You don't do all the things.
It is you who protects all things that are protected. It is you who is the complete, all-pervading spirit, God's divine energy. Think clearly, brain. Speak only the truth. Let your presence in us speak. Let your presence...
Presence in us, in you. Should speak.
In us listen. Let your presence in us bless.
You bless others. By your presence, but in that is the presence of your mother.
Let your presence in us protect. Let your presence in us, your disciples, be the disciple.
You have to be a disciple. A disciple has to obey and not to argue. If you argue, then you are no more a disciple. Disciple temperament is there. See, it's not to argue, but to obey, obedience. Because if you know that it is for your good alone, you should just obey and not to argue. If you argue or pester, then it is not a discipleship. Correct? You must keep the thing prasanna, means pleased. Now,
you are all literature, and you are the ability to understand the literature. You are the divine combination of complete truth, complete happiness, and complete energy. And you are more. You are all knowledge, and you are the use to which the knowledge is put. You exist until the end of all things, and after the end of all things, you are. You create the end of all things, and after the end of all things, you remain indifferent. You are the earth, and you are the water. You are the fire, and you are the air. And you are the space above the air. You are the gunas, and you are beyond the gunas.
And a miracle took place, you see. Linda lit a flame, you see, a fire, quite far away, about 5 feet away from me. And the fire just came and went round me. And she got frightened, thinking that mother is burning. Nothing happened. It went round. And it wants to get to the fire. And the fire moved.
You are the body and you are beyond the body. You are the essence of time and you are beyond time. You and only you exist at the Muladhara Chakra. You are the spirit and you are beyond the spirit. All those who would join God meditate upon you. You are Brahman, Vishnu, Rudra. You are Indra, Agni, Vayu. You are the sun at noon. You are the full moon. Through all these and more, you are the all-pervading energy of innocence and wisdom.
Innocence and wisdom go hand in hand. See, when you are not innocent, you are not wise. You have seen the example of that, of many people coming down here. They have lost their innocence and they have no attention properly made.
You are the divine servant who stoops to wash the feet of saints.
See the humility. See the humility. Just how to make this thing all right, it goes to any limit. Any limit. Just to make you all right. To wash the feet of the disciples. Imagine. Humility. Then how much you should have humility.
You are the tiny core of all things without which the larger have no purpose. You are the key to the libraries of all the scriptures without which the truth is hidden. You are the full stop which completes the sentence and without which the sentence loses its meaning. You are the crescent moon. You are the stars and you are beyond the stars. All things from tiny dot to universe is you. You are in the future and beyond the future. You are in all forms. You are where the sounds combine. You are the silence between the sounds. You are the rhythm of all music and all prayers. This is the knowledge of Nirmal Ganesh, and you, Nirmal Ganesh, are the master of that knowledge and all knowledge.
Yes, we should leave it.
You are the God and you are the Goddess.
Well, left we should
leave. Om Gam Nirmal Ganapataye. To your powers, Ganesha, let all surrender. Let the left side of memory and the right side of action surrender to you. And let your enlightenment prevail.
Just take the lead. Oh. Oh. What happened? Can you take
me? Hands. One holding a rope, the second a goad, the third is raised in blessing, and the fourth offers sustenance. Your banner is that of a humble mouse. You have long ears and are clothed in red. Red decorates you, and you are worshipped with red flowers. You have compassion for those who love you, and it is for those who love you that you come to Aum Gyom Nirmal Jesusye. To your powers, Aum Jesus, let all surrender. Let the left side of memory and the right side of action surrender to you. And let your enlightenment prevail. You are the Word that was the beginning. You are the Word that will be the ending. You are He who was born of a virgin and died on the cross.
Thank you. from my mother's house. My father's house. Very interesting. This is from Ganesha, you can see.
The Rishi said, of your Indra sovereignty over the three worlds and his share of the sacrifices were taken away by the Asuras Shumba and Nishumba by force of their pride and strength. The two themselves took over likewise the offices of the sun, the moon, Kubera, Yama and Varuna.
Gavin, you come this side so somebody can repeat something.
Did Vayu's authority and Agni's duty, deprived of their lordships and sovereignties, the Devas were defeated, deprived of their functions and expelled by these two great Asuras. All the Devas thought of the invincible Devi. She had granted us the boon. Whenever in calamities you think of me, that very moment I will put an end to all your worst calamities. Resolving thus, the Devas went to Himava, Lord of the Mountains, and there extolled the Devi, who is the elusive power of Vishnu. The Devas said, salutation to the Devi, to the Mahadevi. Salutation always to her who is ever auspicious. Salutation to her who is the primordial cause and the sustaining power. With attention, we have made obeisance to her. Salutation to her who is terrible, to her who is eternal. Salutation to Gauri, the supporter of the universe. Salutation always to her who is of the form of the moon, and is moonlight and happiness itself. We bow to her who is welfare. We make salutations to her who is prosperity and success. Salutation to the consort of Shiva, who is herself the good fortune, as well as the misfortune of kings. Salutation always to Durga, who takes one across difficulties, who is essence, who is the author of everything, who is the knowledge of discrimination. And who is blue-black, as also smoke-like in complexion. We prostrate before her, who is at once most gentle and most terrible. We salute her again and again. Salutation to her, who is the support of the world. Salutation to the Devi, who is of the form of volition. Salutations again and again to the Devi, who in all beings is called Vishnu Maya.
Very important, left it should be. Vishnu Maya.
Salutations again and again to the Devi, who in all beings is termed as consciousness. Salutations again and again to the Devi, who abides in all beings in the form of intelligence. Salutations again and again to the Devi.
Intelligence is little. Intelligence actually it means subuddhi. It means the one that's a real sharp, pure intelligence. You can say pure intelligence is better.
Salutation to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of sleep. Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of hunger. Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of reflection. Salutations again and again to the Devi
who abides in all beings in the form of power. Salutations again and again to the Devi, who abides in all beings in the form of thirst. Salutations to the Devi, who abides in all beings in the form of forgiveness. Salutations to the Devi, who abides in all beings in the form of genus. Salutations to the Devi, who abides in all beings in the form of modesty.
So one has to be modest, you see. Those who are not modest, those who use harsh words, who are hot-tempered, who try to show off, talk in a very sharp way, are not near me. You have to talk in a sweet, modest way. Modesty is a sign of your proper breeding. If you are ill-bred, then you don't know how to talk modestly. And that will, the blame comes to your mother. There was somebody who talked very sharply the other day, in a sharper way, and tried to show off a little bit. And there were some people who had come outsiders. They saw it and they were surprised. Yes, it's true. You have to be extremely honest.
Salutations again and again to the day. It abides in all beings in the form of peace. Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of faith.
Faith. See, what gives you faith also? What makes you believe it is that power.
Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of loveliness.
You have to be a lovely person and not a crude person, not uncouth, but a lovely person.
Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of good fortune.
And that's how the good fortune comes to us.
Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of activity. Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of memory. Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of compassion.
Memory now, memory. I think I know, I think I, it is there, I think. That's not the way memory is, you know. This is it. That's all. If you test your memory like that, yes, I know this is it.
Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of contentment.
Contentment.
Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of mother.
That's what I said, contentment is not discontented. That you, this is not there, so you are unhappy, that is not there, so you are, I am unhappy. That is not the way you should describe yourself. You should never be unhappy. Everything is alright, we manage with this, we manage with that. Contentment is whatever you are, to be contented. That's how you are using the power, otherwise you are not using it.
Salutations again and again to the Devi who abides in all beings in the form of error.
That's a good one. I told you, if you don't make errors, you won't reach the right place. You won't learn and you won't reach. Error, it is little bit error here and then you find it there, you see.
Salutations to the all-pervading Devi, who constantly presides over the senses of all beings and governs all the elements. Salutations again and again to her who, pervading this entire world, abides in the form of consciousness. Invoked of you all by the Devas for the sake of their desired object and adored by the
Lord. Now you are the Devas, alright? So you have to invoke those powers.
Adored by the Lord of the Devas every day. May she be Ishvari, the source of all good, accomplish for us all auspicious things, and put an end to our calamities. And who is now again reverenced by us, devas, tormented by arrogant asuras.
And who...
Dear brothers and sisters, dear Sahajyogis, Sahajyoginis, dear friends, it's very difficult to speak before a gathering like this. But all I can say is I regard myself as very greatly privileged to be a part of this marvelous family that I see here. You know, I am serving myself the United Nations system. And the United Nations system is based on idealism, on the belief that all human beings are of one family. But that is the basis, that is the philosophy, that is the foundation, and we have to make that work. We, those who are privileged to serve that system, have to work in such a way that this philosophy is realized. Now that is one plane, the plane of the United Nations. It's a very, very hard, long way. But what I have found myself is that in the world of today, the problems that we face are not problems of material well-being. Science, technology, revolution, they have all brought within our reach the resources which Mother Earth makes available, and all of us can be happy. All of us can be reasonably well off. And yet we are not. Is it because technology has not advanced? Is it because our knowledge of science is inadequate? No. There's only one major element, and that major element is the human element. It is the human being at his best, that can make this world a happy place for all of us. In other words, if mankind has to live and have to survive, you know, we are living in a dangerous world, in a nuclear age. If mankind has to survive, then we can survive only on the principle of love, on the basis that there is a great human evolution, spiritual evolution. Spiritual evolution does not mean that you get away from materialism. It means that the perspectives are right, that the prime importance given to a spirit, it is spiritual evolution which alone can make people feel that they are one, that they are part of a family. Now the message that you are giving to the world, that is the message which the world needs. It needs a new Messiah, someone who will tell the world that we are all one, but we are all one in reality. We must speak not from just our lips, but from our hearts. We must sincerely believe that we are one, and if that message can get across, then alone human beings will survive and mankind will be at peace within itself, we will be happy. And when I see this family, my idealism gets greatly strengthened. Because in you I see a wonderful gathering of people from all parts of the world, speaking different languages, professing different religions, and yet being together as if forever and ever you have been together, as if you have belonged to one family. The way I have seen you all, for example, here in this house or anywhere else, working together as if it is a festivity, it's not work. No matter what the problems, facilities, none. implements very few. But the marvelous spirit, it is that spirit which is within you, which fills me with emotion, with sentiment, with feeling, with admiration. And I feel that there is still hope for mankind. What you are doing is a practical demonstration of human nature when it's developed, when it is at its best. You know, there have been philosophers of all kinds in this world. Philosophers, some of them have said, human nature is essentially nasty and brutish and short. This was Jack Hobbes. I don't agree with that at all. You may look at something and propound a philosophy, but your understanding may be totally wrong. There are others who have held human nature must be seen at its best if you want to know what human nature is. And I'm not trying to please you, but honestly, when I see you and your faces enlightened, kind, noble, I feel very elated. And it is this which fills me with strength. It gives me strength because in my own work, which is at another level, a much lower level, you are at a very high level. I get strength from that. But there are ever so many frustrations in workaday world, workaday life. When I come to you, I'm near you, I feel that there is hope for mankind, and we all can look forward to a better future. Now, this lady has been with me for many, many years. we got married decades ago. And she has been a source of great strength to me as a wife. But I know in what affection and what respect you hold her. And this relationship, again, is a fantastic relationship. I can assure you that she has always felt for everyone, not just now. We have had, for example, relations in our family, my own daughters and the children of others living with us. She always thought, in reality, all of them to be precisely the same. And today, she probably belongs to me 0.1%, she belongs 99.9% to all of you. But I'm happy about it. Because I want to see this kind of relationship develop, become a reality, where all of us can say mine and thine and ours together. And this is the way you are. What can I say to you on this occasion? I want to express only my genuine joy, admiration, and a prayer that the Almighty may strengthen this spark of divinity in you, that you may be the forebears of a new message for mankind. You know, messages for mankind, they don't begin with millions, they always begin with a few, but a large, growing number. And your strength of will, your determination, may well turn a new page in history. You do not know what perilous days we are passing through. That's on one side, but there is on the other side another movement, which, to my way of thinking, is the movement that the world needs today. So may I end my words by expressing my very sincere gratitude, not only for what you are doing, but much more for the new message that you are building. As a citizen of the world, I pray that your efforts may succeed, may have glorious success. Please remain strengthened, firm in your belief that what you are doing is what the world needs. And in a spirit of humility, which I see abounding, idealism, joy, mutual love, please carry on and regard me as a part of that, small part of that endeavor. I thank you again for giving me this wonderful opportunity to be with you all this evening. I'm delighted that in this humble abode, we're all together, that we are making a beginning with joy, with this wonderful togetherness. And I'm too full now of emotion to be able to say more. May God bless you all. A Merry Christmas. a happy new year to all of you. Thank you very much.